Hello, this is Jeremy Patrick, your professor for this course. I wanted to introduce to you Proctorio. Proctorio is the proctoring service that we'll be using at this institution. So it's actually a really great proctoring service that allows you to take exams pretty much anywhere, from home, at a library, wherever you might need some time alone. There are some restrictions within Proctorio and different rules. Every professor may adapt and use it differently. I'll be utilizing it specifically as a lockdown browser, meaning that you won't be able to, once you have your computer going for your exam, you won't be able to open a browser to Google something, okay? So let's talk about it real quick. So let's say I want to take this exam. Well, the first thing that's going to pop up is this guy right here. The extension is required is what it states. So what do I need to do? I'm going to need to enable and download Proctorio for this browser. So to begin, you must use Google Chrome. It will not work on Safari. It will not work on Firefox. It won't work on Internet Explorer. It must be Google Chrome. The second thing is you must be signed into your Google account, your Gmail account, whatever it might be. You have to be signed into that first. So you click here and it says, excellent, I'm using Google Chrome, done. The next thing is I must install the Proctorio Chrome extension. So you click here. I can then, I've already downloaded it, so I don't need to remove it. Otherwise this would say add, so I can enable since I already have it on here. If you do not have it, you would then click this button because it says to download. So now you can see this little, this armor little shield. That means that that's the secure exam proctor, so I'm good to go. So I can close this now. Step two, install it, done. Step three, done. Why? Because I'm using Google Chrome and my computer has a capability to a webcam. We will not be using the webcam for this course. So now I can close that as well. So that's next. Well, that big orange box is now gone, saying that I am not prepared and able to do this. Some students, if you do not do that, it will ask you for an access code to take the exam. I do not have access codes to these exams. Proctorio is the only one with the access code. Proctorio, this little shield here, will add the code to the test for you automatically, assuming that when you hit take the quiz that you have passed all of these requirements. So as you can see, during the exam, you will not be able to put things in your clipboard. You will not be able to disconnect additional screens or monitors. You will not be able to right click or open tabs. You cannot print anything. Excellent, excellent, excellent. So if your Proctorio is activated, you're signed into your Google Chrome and you're all ready to go, it'll say I accept and you begin the exam now. If this does not show, then you did not meet all of those requirements from before. So make sure that you are very clear as to how you log into those things. I'm going to back out of here because I'm not ready to take my test. So I'm going to click on this again, and you can see there's also a page here, how to use it. There's videos. This is provided from the college on how you access these things, how you install it. So there's lots of resources. Now, the key is you must do this before you're taking the test. Do not wait until you're going to take the test at the last hour, because there are possibilities that you're going to have challenges using Proctorio. What are some of those challenges? Well, the challenge might be your computer just does not have the bandwidth, or it's just too old. Or maybe all you have is your cell phone that will not work. So there are restrictions to Proctorio. Make sure that you follow them and try early. Make sure that you have access to everything, because if you don't, then reach out to me so we can try to partner with how we can get you the technology or get you set up in a place that has the technology so you can take this exam. Students often will just borrow a friend's laptop. They'll use their devices just for that purpose, for the test. Again, all of this is free for you to use. Again, I'm only using it as a lockdown browser. I'm not recording it. Every professor has the opportunity to use Proctorio to a lot of different restrictions. So since I do allow you notes on your exams, I opted to not record you. I am watching the screen. I can see how you're accessing the test and how you're going through it, but I'm not going to ask you to use your IDs to log in and to then also move your computer around the room. So that being said, make sure you read the instructions. When you're ready to take the quiz, everything is good. You click accept, and there you go. So that being said, good luck on your exams, and we'll talk soon.